This is a huge issue, whether voucher schools need to give the same No Child Left Behind tests that the public schools have to give.
Right.
And so this has become an issue in Florida.
In Florida right now, it's Republican versus Republican. You have Republicans in the state house who are trying to pass the bill. They're trying to oppose the standardized testing of voucher students in Florida.
Okay.
And then you have Senate Republicans who won't expand the voucher program without those kind of testing requirements.
Right.
So
it's kind of the you might say the anti-Common Core Republican flank against the accountability Republican flank.
Right.
You might say, right? But go ahead, Andrew.
It's a little bit more complicated and nuanced in Florida because with the existing tax credit program, students in that program have to take some norm-referenced or standardized test, but the state does not prescribe what tests the schools administer. Most of them do the Stanford test, others do different types of tests, but you can crosswalk the results of those tests to the state test, which currently is the FCAT. But the issue is, you know, the House doesn't want to change this because it's been working. There's a senator who's a Republican and actually has been a big champion of school choice in my district here in Florida who wants to have the state test given to the tax credit kids. But we don't know because of Common Core what the state test will be next year, if it's going to be PARC, if it's going to be something else, if we're going to revise the FCAT. So it's really confusing. And my hope was that they'd expand the program and come to some sort of middle ground agreement on the types of tests that schools could administer, but it looks like, for all intents and purposes, it's dead for this year.
What is it you'd like to happen? You'd like some kind of test to be required? I mean, speaking for yourself, of course, not your group. You'd like some kind of test to be required, but not necessarily. Go ahead.
There already is a requirement that students in the Step Up for Students program are tested by their schools.
Right.
And I think that, you know, it would make sense if perhaps, you know, as a means of negotiation, they were to identify, you know, 5 to 10 norm reference standardized tests that would be appropriate. I find it personally kind of ridiculous that you can say there's only one test out there that can possibly measure the performance of kids in a state. And I've always been one to question the need to develop more and new tests based on standards. I think you can crosswalk the results of one test to different standards and save yourselves tens of millions of dollars, but who am I to comment on that?
And so one might argue, just to belabor this one extra second, Andrew, is that if the voucher schools would have, or the tax credit schools, I guess is a more accurate term in Florida, if they would have the option between tests, as you're describing, which could include the FCAT, the state No Child Left Behind test, why not let public schools have the option, the same option? Does that make sense to you?
Well, that's a great question, Bob. I'm not going to weigh in on that one. I think that with school choice, you have the encouragement for innovation, and the good thing about Florida is that we have a robust school choice program. There's a lot of accountability. There is that testing requirement. And it's a system that is designed to give kids an alternative to the traditional system. How the traditional system chooses to run itself, I don't feel expert enough to comment on the state test. However, I will say this. If you're going to have a testing requirement anywhere, you got to figure out what test you're going to give. And we don't know what test the state's going to give next year.
Okay.